Hello students, welcome to the next video of science. Okay, our today's topic is housing and clothing. Students, as you all know that all the living organism, including all the animals, birds and we human beings, all need a place to live. Okay, so the place where an organism live, is known as shelter or the home of that animals. As all, you have already studied in class 1 and 2 that homes of different animals. Okay, just as cow live in a shed, cow live in a shed, dog live in a kennel, okay, horse live in a stable, okay. In this way, our rabbit lives in a burrow. Okay, student. So, in this way, different animals have different kinds of home, or they live at different place. And the place where an organism live is known as shelter or the home of that animals. We also live in a the place where we live. We call it as our home. The birds stays on the trees. You all have seen the birds. Okay. So the trees are the homes of the birds or the shelter of the birds. Okay. And the animals such as monkeys, bear, and many other animals stay on the trees. So trees are their home. Okay. So the place where an organism lives is known as the shelter or the home of that animal. Okay, student. So but the question is, why do we need a place? Okay, why do all the living organism needs a place to live? All the living organism needs a place to keep themselves safe from their enemies. Okay, but we are going to discuss that why do we need a house? We need a house to protect ourselves from heat. Heat. Okay. As you can see, these days it is very hot. Okay. And in the daytime, after our classes, where do you go? Do you go for playing outside at the daytime in the afternoon? No. You just sit inside your home under the fan or the AC or the coolers. Okay. So, a house protects us from heat. Okay. So, a house protects us from heat. Okay, student. Now, second one is cold. In winters, what do we do? When the climate is cloudy, what do we do? We just sit inside our home. Okay. And we use heaters. In winter season, when the climate is very cold, what do we do? Do we play outside? No, we don't play. If the climate is very cloudy that day, what do we do? We just sit inside our home. We just use our heaters, na? Yes, or we in winters we wear a lot of clothes. Okay, sweater, muffler, trouser, a lot of clothes we wear. And even that, when we feel cold, we just sit inside our house. We don't go outside. Okay, student. So a house also protects us from cold. And the climate, you have seen in the television also, where there is snowfall in winters, people don't come out of their houses for many days. Okay, they stay just inside their houses. Okay, and if there is rain in winter season, then also the people just keep sit inside their homes or do whatever do they in their house, but they don't come outside the house. So to keep themselves safe from the cold weather. Okay, so in this way, our house also protects us from cold. Third one is rain. Okay, student, you all play in the evening? Yes or no? Yes. You all play in the evening? Yes, all the children used to play in the evening. ओके, बट इफ देयर इज रेन, इफ सम बट सपोज इफ देयर इज रेन रेन एट दैट टाइम व्हाट यू डू, यू जस्ट कम इनसाइड योर होम एंड सिट, यस यू जस्ट रन अवे फ्रॉम द प्लेग्राउंड एंड जस्ट कम इनसाइड योर हाउस, यस और नो, यस ओके. सो अ हाउस प्रोटेक्ट्स अस फ्रॉम रेन, अ हाउस प्रोटेक्ट्स अस फ्रॉम रेन, ओके. Now the another one is wind. When the climate is windy, air is coming out, heavy air blows with the dust, which carry dust and germs. Okay, so what we do? जब बहुत तेज आंधी चलती है, there is a we can say wind is blowing with very high speed and it has included germs and dust. Okay, and the dust goes inside our eyes. What do? We just come inside our home. So, a house also protects us from wind. Okay, student. Now, the fifth one is thieves. Okay. Ever you have the you have hear about it or. You have heard in the news also in from the newspaper or from your parents or grandparents that somebody was gone somewhere and thieves have taken their all the things. Okay, if we put our things outside our home, okay, if we put our something outside our home, what the thieves will do? Thieves will come and take away. Okay, student, if we put our things outside our home, then the thieves will come and take it away. Okay, and if we if in night time if we sleep outside outside our home, do we sleep outside our home? Have you ever seen that your parents sleep outside the home? No. Why? Because the thieves may come and kill us. So a house also protects us from thieves, or we are safe inside our houses. Okay, student. So now the sixth one is wild animals. Wild animals. Okay, student. A house also protects us from wild animals. The people living near the you can see the near the jungle. If they will sleep outside, what the wild animals will do? Wild animals will come and just kill them. Yes, you might have heard from their parents or grandparents that in newspaper it comes that the people were in village area, people were sleeping outside the house, and the that leopard came and picked them up. This happens in village areas. So a house also protects us from wild animals. So today we have discussed about why do we need a house. We need a house because a house protects us from heat, cold, rain, wind, thieves and wild animals. Okay, so a house protects us from heat, cold, rain, wind, thieves and wild animals. Okay, student, now we are going to study about the different types of houses. Students, we are going to study about the types of houses. Types of houses, there are mainly two types of houses: permanent house and temporary house. Okay, permanent house fixed at one place. Permanent house are fixed at one place. Okay, number one is permanent house. Okay, permanent house, you can see permanent that as furniture in our house is permanently placed at one place. Okay, as the furniture in her house is permanently placed, or you can say that TV is fixed at permanently at one point. So means we don't take the TV one day here and the next day there. Okay, see, so we keep it at one place, permanently at one place. Okay, so the permanent means fixed at one place. As in our house, our TV, fridge are fixed at one place. Okay, we keep them at one place. We do not move them एवरी डे फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस. ओके बट वी कैन वी कीप मूविंग अवर व्हीकल्स, चेयर्स, ओके अवर क्लोथ्स, सो दे आर नॉट परमानेंटली प्लेस्ड. ओके सो द परमानेंट मीन्स, वॉट डू यू मीन बाय परमानेंट? परमानेंट मीन्स द थिंग विच इज फिक्स्ड एट वन प्लेस, परमानेंटली फिक्स्ड एट वन प्लेस. सो सम हाउसेस आर permanent house means they are permanently fixed at one place, they cannot be taken from one place to another place. So permanent house, there are two types of permanent house. One is kachcha house, number one is a part is kachcha house. Okay student, kachcha house. Okay, if you might have visited any village area, you have seen houses there. Have you seen houses there? There the houses are made up of mud, bamboo sticks, straw and stones. Okay, so these types of houses known as kachcha house. Okay, and these mostly these types of houses we can see in village areas. Mostly this type of houses we see in the village areas. Okay student, a kachcha house is made up of mud, straw, bamboo stick, etc. Okay, bamboo stick, etc. Now the pakka house. Second one is pakka house. Okay, pakka house. This types of house, the house we live in is also pakka house. Okay, so these types of houses we see in the cities. Okay, and pakka houses are made up of cement, bricks, iron, steel, etc. Okay, steel, etc. Okay, student. And you might have visited, if the construction is going on near your house, around your house, so you might have seen the material used to make a pakka house. Okay, student. So, first one is permanent house. Permanent house are of two types, kachcha house and pakka house. Okay student, now temporary houses. Number two is temporary houses. Okay student, temporary houses. So temporary house means house that are not fixed at one place. Houses that are not fixed at one place is we can carry them from one place to another places. So these types of houses are tent. Number one is tent. Okay, tent. It is made up of thick cloth. A tent is made up of thick cloth. Okay, I'll show you the picture also. Okay, so see, okay, student, there are mainly two types of houses. One is permanent house. Okay, permanent houses are of two types: kachcha house and pakka house. Kachcha house, as you can see in the picture, these types of houses are mostly visible in village areas. Okay, and a kachcha house is made up of mud, straw, wood. Okay, and we can see these types of houses in village areas. Okay student, now the second one is a pakka house. Okay, these types of houses are mostly visible in cities. Okay, also a pakka house is made up of bricks, cement, iron and steel. Okay, now the temporary houses are not fixed at one place. Okay, so number one is tent. As you can see in the picture, there is a tent. A tent is made up of thick cloth. Okay, a tent is made up of thick cloth, and the soldiers and the people who go for trekking live in this tent or carry this type of tent along with themselves. This is very convenient to carry along with themselves. Okay, now the next one is caravan. Caravan is a house on wheel. It is also known as a house on wheels, as in this all the facilities like house are there. Okay, we have kitchen, we have washroom, we have living room, everything is there. So it is also known as a house on wheels. Okay, and the people who keep moving from one place to another place carry these types of houses. Okay student, now the next one is houseboat. Okay, as you can see this, it is a house on boat. Okay, this is a boat and a house is there. So this is a house on boat. Okay, so a houseboat is a house that floats on water. Okay, a houseboat is a house that floats on water, and we see this such type of houses mainly in Kashmir and Kerala. Okay, the places where we see this type of houses are Kashmir and Kerala. Okay, student. Now the next one is igloo. Igloo, you can see in this picture, this is an igloo. Igloo is made up of ice blocks. Okay, igloo is made up of ice blocks, and igloos are found in very cold places. Okay, student. Igloos are found in very close places, and the people living in igloo are known as Eskimos. Okay, student. Student, we have studied about the different types of houses. Okay, now we are going to study about the features of a good house. How people can say that a house is good? Okay, so a house should allow proper sunlight to come during the day, because sunlight helps to kill the germs. Okay, and and keep our house free from germs. Okay, student, a house should allow proper sunlight to come inside, so that the sunlight is very helpful to us, as it kills the germs inside our house and makes our house germs free. Okay, so the house should be such that it should the sunlight can come inside. Means we should have a proper doors and windows. Okay, and you might have seen in the morning your parents or the grandparents just open all the doors and windows so that sunlight can come inside our home. Why? Because sunlight kills the germs and makes our house germs free. Okay, student. So now the second thing is, a house should be well ventilated. A house should be well ventilated. Okay, first point, sunlight should come into our house. Okay, sunlight should come into our house. Okay, student. Now the second one is, a house should be well ventilated and airy. Okay, a house should be well ventilated. I'm writing in short because I can't write all thing on the blackboard. Our house should be well ventilated and airy. Okay, so well ventilated means we should have proper doors and windows. Because why we should have proper doors and windows in our house? Because they allow fresh air to come inside and bad airs to go outside. Okay, student. Third one is, we should grow plants around our house. Okay, grow plants around our house. Okay, why we should grow plants around our house? Why? Because they help to clean the air and give us fresh air to breathe. Okay, student, this you all know that we all take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. Okay, student, and the carbon dioxide is absorbed by the plant and they give out oxygen. So we should grow plants around our house. Okay, student, they absorb the bad air and give us fresh air to breathe. Okay, student, number 4 is, doors and windows should be fitted with wire nets. Why? Doors and windows should be fitted with wire nets. Doors and windows. Windows should be fitted with wire nets. Okay, student. Yes, doors and windows should be fitted with wire nets because to keep the mosquitoes and house flies away, है ना. Doors and windows should be fitted with wire net so that it can keep away flies and mosquitoes. Okay, and bathrooms and toilets should be cleaned properly. Fifth one is bathrooms and toilets should be cleaned properly. Okay, student. Thank you, student. We have to close this video. We are closing this video here only, and we will discuss further in our next video. Okay, student. Thank you.